You're enjoying this!
Attention, there's been a nasty five frog curse near the M4. Proceed immediately to the area.
Oh dear.
Looks bad.
Very bad.
Quite agreed. Only one thing to do with a multiple frog curse like this.
Righto, get the magic wand.
Clear the area. Fire!
Prescriptions, yeah? Who's got the pops? Come on, who's got the pops? Come on. Who's got a boil on the bum? Boil on the body. Who's got the chest rash? Have to get a bigger bottle. Who's got... who's got wind? Catch.
The BBC would like to apologise for the poor quality of the writing in that sketch. It is not BBC policy to get easy laughs with words like bum, knickers, botty or wee-wees.
Shh! These are the words which are not to be used again on this programme.
Semprini, then.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. I'd like some aftershave, please.
Ah, certainly, sir. Walk this way, please.
If I could walk that way, I wouldn't need aftershave. Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Can I help you?
Yes, I'd like some aftershave, please.
Ah, a toilet requisite. Would you like to try this, sir? It's our very latest. It's called Sea Mist.
I quite like it.
How about something a little more musky? This one's called Nimmo.
Not really, no. Have you anything a little fishier?
Fishier?
Fishier.
Fish, fish, fish. A fishy requisite.
Like halibut or sea bass.
Or bream?
Yes.
Oh, we haven't got any of that. I've got mackerel or cod or hake.
You haven't got anything a little more halibutish?
Parrot? What's that doing there? Or skate with just a hint of prawn? Or crab, tiger and almonds? Very unusual.
I really had my heart set on halibut.
Well, sir, we had a fishy consignment in this morning, so I could nip down to the basement and see if I can come up trumps with this particular requisite. So it was halibut or...
sea bass.
Sea bass. Won't be a moment.
Sorry about this. Normally we try and avoid these little pauses, longers. Only dramatically he's gone down to the basement, you see. Of course there isn't really a basement, but he just goes off and we pretend. Actually what happens is he just goes off there, off camera, and just waits there so it looks as though he's gone down to the basement. Actually, I think he's rather overdoing it. Ah!
Oh, sorry, sir. Lot of steps. Well, I'm afraid he didn't come in this morning, sir, but we have got some down at our Kensington branch. I'll just nip down there and get it for you.
Oh, how long will that be?
20 minutes.
20 minutes? Pom, pom. Oh, I wonder what other people use for aftershave lotion.
I use a body rub called halitosis. It makes my breath seem sweet. I use an aftershave called Semprini.
sorry, I can't stop now. I've got to get to Kensington. I use two kinds of aftershave lotion. Frankincense, myrrh, three kinds of aftershave lotion. Frankincense, myrrh, sandal, four kinds of aftershave lotion. Frankincense.
I have a cold shower every morning just before I go mad. And then I go mad. One, mad, two, mad, three, mad, four.
I use rancid polecat number two. Keeps my skin nice and scaly.
Oh, sorry again. Can't stop. Got to get back.
Well, I'm afraid they don't have any on our Kensington branch, but we have got some down at the depot.
Where's that?
Aberdeen.
Aberdeen?
It's all right, you wait here. I've got a car.
No, I'll take the other. The crab, tiger and...
Almond requisite.
I'll take it.
This
man has been a shoplifting officer.
Oh, yes?
Yes.
Are you trying to tell me my job?
No, but he's been shoplifting.
Look, I must warn you that anything you may say will be ignored. And furthermore, given half a chance, I'll put my fist through your teeth. For tang, for tang!
But, officer, this man here...
Look, been... I've had enough of you. You're under arrest.
Officer, it wasn't him. He's the shoplifter.
No, I'm not.
He's not. I'm a witness.
Look, one more peep out of you and I'll do you for heresy.
Heresy? Blimey, I didn't expect the Spanish Inquisition.
Shut up! Fatang, fatang! Oh, that's nice. Right, I'm taking you along to the station.
What for?
I'm charging you with illegal possession of whatever we happen to have down there. Right, lunar module calling Buzz Aldrin, come in. Raindrops keep falling on my head. But that doesn't mean that much.
The BBC would like to apologise to the police about the character of Police Constable Pan Am. He was not meant to represent the average police officer. Similarly, the reference to Buzz Aldrin, the astronaut, was the product of a disordered mind and should not be construed as having any other significance.